One of the things to know about hummingbirds is they're a massive enigma. Because hummingbirds are so tiny, a lot of the trackers and gear that we have for bigger animals to know how they're spending their days and what they're eating is just too big for a hummingbird. So we have to kind of zoom out and say, what can we get? What can we know? So this setup is allowing us to learn a ton about some things that hummingbirds regularly do, right? They're always flying and they're always eating. Behind us is our kind of everything we can capture at one moment setup, which means we have a captive hummingbird in this flight arena. We're getting information about what that bird's metabolism is like, how it's flying, where it's flying, how it's feeding. And getting kind of the start of a big picture of how hummingbirds exist in nature in a lab with some really controlled conditions and with some really high-tech equipment to collect them.
Right now, we have been ironing out the methods to work with the bird that we have here. This is actually our first bird that we have in the setup. This setup is nice because it's basically a cube with transparent walls, so you can see with high-speed cameras how the hummingbird is moving.
These cameras that are attached onto the arena itself, they're high-speed cameras that can capture up to about 2,500 frames per second. So they're incredibly high-speed cameras, and we're using them to measure how hummingbirds fly. So those three camera shots are gonna get calibrated to create this sort of 3D space so that we can see when the wings of the hummingbird are moving, where they're moving, how far they're moving back, what type of figure eight pattern looks like, and how it changes depending on if they're hovering versus moving away from the feeder versus approaching the feeder. We're also using some metabolism equipment. What it allows us to do is to measure the exhaled breath of the bird and how much energy it's consuming. So we can see how much oxygen is dipping between the environment versus when the bird feeds, and how much the carbon dioxide is peaking in the bird's exhaled breath compared to the environment around us in here.
So the cool thing with this setup is that it is very versatile. So for instance, we want to answer the question of how they use energy and acquire energy differently when feeding from different types of flowers. For instance, feeding from upright flowers all the way to pendant flowers. In nature, you can see that they use all of these different kinds of resources, but we don't know how much energy they are differentially investing in taking advantage of them. So that's one of the questions that we can solve. With the camera that is looking at the bird's bill and tongue, we can solve a totally different set of questions related to the detailed morphology of the feeding apparatus. So how different bills and tongues collect nectar differently.
We are doing all this with captive birds to kind of give us a really good foundation to bring all this in the field. So we do a lot of research in Colombia, and we're gonna do similar work there. But the big difference is we've actually planned to, instead of doing this with captive hummingbirds, we're gonna do this with hummingbirds that can come and go at will. So the field station we work at, hummingbirds are really used to coming to. They love the nectar, they love coming by. And so we're gonna try to put this whole setup just in the window of our field station.
Through that window, we train hummingbirds, wild hummingbirds, to come in and drink from the same setup, fly and being recorded with the same cameras and do all of the energetic measurements, but with entirely free living birds. And that's what is so powerful about what we do here, that we can directly connect with what the birds face out there in nature.